Zach, how's it feel to have another perfect season here at Frost Arena, go out on senior night like that?
I mean, we were just talking about out there. I mean, what if you lost? And we're like, that would suck. But, yeah, it's been awesome. Every time we've done it like that after the game, I know I can remember Griff's after Western was really fun because he was from Illinois. I remember that one. And then last year, obviously, we won. And I probably the year before that, we probably won, too. I don't remember. But, yeah, it's awesome. And, you know, we got the best fans in the Summit, and not every school gets an atmosphere like that for every home game. And pretty much every home game we have, people show up and support us, and that makes it a lot more fun.
I believe you guys clinched one of the top two seeds tonight. Is that pretty important with how the Summit League tournament plays out, get that day off in between?
I don't know. I guess we haven't really talked about it, but yeah, I mean, it's nice getting that, playing the first day, getting the next day off just for preparation, because otherwise you play, go back to the hotel, eat quick, and then it's filmed till, you know, whenever, and then you go to bed and get up and you just feel like you're cramming everything. But so that's important from that standpoint.
Cody, on the score sheet it says we had a 6-point advantage in points in the paint. What kind of led you guys to be able to take that advantage from them?
I think it starts with our rebounding, you know, limiting their second chance points, because the first time we played them, they had way too many offensive rebounds, and you know, our guys stepped up and really, you know, took it to heart that they're going to box their guy out and get the rebounds, and I think that's honestly why that is.
Cody, did you feel like when you guys got off to such a hot start that you kind of, whether it frustrated them or overwhelmed them? I mean, it seemed like whether it was the crowd or whatever, when it was like 27-8, that you were really taking it to them a little bit there.
Yeah, I honestly did. I looked up, but that was probably the score I saw, 27-8, and I was like, man, I didn't know it was like this. I mean, our guys are just playing hard and playing aggressive, and when we do that, well, that's when we're at our best, and you know, we got to keep it going.
When you guys are shooting the three like that, I mean, does that, do you look to get those two guys the hot hand when you can see that they're hot like that, regardless of maybe what you're planning on doing, they're hitting threes like that, you start saying, hey, let's feed those guys the ball.
Yeah, and I mean, their shots will come in our offense, and that's kind of how it works. Is the, you know, everybody's touching the ball, and you know, whoever's scoring is going to score the ball, and you know, we're so unselfish that, you know, we want to get the other guy involved, and you know, we're very good at that.
Had to be good to see how many guys came off the bench today and played really well. You got a lot of good minutes from a lot of guys, even some young guys too.
Yeah, and I think that starts in practice. Our young guys are really. They're making us better. The scout team is making us better, and you know, they're getting better so fast. And you know, the young guys these past couple games have really stepped up and played a big role, and we need that out of them.
You good?
I just thought we were really sharp tonight. A little slow offensively, probably the first 3 or 4 minutes, and then. We really picked up the pace. I thought George started pushing the ball, and we got a couple trail ball screens from Cody, which they struggle with, and it's hard to go underneath George's ball screens because he's shooting it so well. And then, you know, that our pace really picked up offensively, and that's kind of when it took off. But, you know, it starts with defense. And the one thing we've been doing a pretty good job of here maybe the past 3 games is rebounding the basketball. We've been blocking out better, haven't been getting up offensive rebounds. So. That's been a big reason for our push.
You want to comment about the seniors as well?
Yeah, I mean, you know, just like I said out there, you know, you look at Zach's 4 years. I don't know if there's been a more successful guy in the Division I era in terms of the wins we've had since he's been on our team, and certainly. You know, he has a lot to do with that. Cody has a lot to do with it. We're so thrilled that he came to us 2 years ago, even though there was some buzz about it and some concern about it. He's been nothing but tremendous off the floor. They're both great students. Like I said, they'll both be tremendous leaders in their community. And just proud that I had a chance for them to be in my life.
Questions for Coach?
Scott? Is it something that you are concerned with as far as clinching a top two seed in the conference tournament?
I don't understand. Am I concerned?
Well, I mean, is that something that matters to you?
Yeah. I think that's pretty important. You know, if you can play on the first night and win, which won't be easy for anybody this year. I think any of the games, you know, could go either way. But if you can win that first night, then I think having that extra night of rest, you know, because it's hard to go 3 nights in a row and win all 3 games.
Thank you.
another perfect season at home. I mean, can you sort of, what do you attribute you guys' home success to?
Good players, number one. I think above everything else, that's what you have to have if you want to win. And then we've got great fans that give us a lot of energy, and you know, it's been, you know, it's a win-win for everybody. It's great for our players, and it's been great for our fans. When you look at even both the men and women and how we've done here this year, it's just been a tremendous season for both.
Last time you were home, Ian, is it Tyson?
Tyson.
Yep.
Had kind of a tough game, and I thought he came in the first half and gave you some really good minutes off the bench. Obviously, when you extended the lead, you got to give all those guys some more minutes. But
yeah, I thought it was probably Ian's best game. I thought he was pretty active, made some nice plays defensively, because they were working hard to throw the ball at post, and I thought that he was doing a good job of trying to keep it out of there. You know, their freshman kid, I thought, played well. Obviously, had 18 points tonight. But, you know, I mean, a post player can only guard another post player for so long. You can't let him dribble four or five times without getting some help from the guards. And that's the one thing we didn't do very well in the first half. But Ian did everything he could do to fight him. And then, you know, in the second half, he got off to a nice little start offensively, too.
And like I said, it wasn't just him. I mean, you got to give several guys some good minutes tonight. It looked like they did good things.
Yeah, we were able to, you know, like Skyler and Lane and some of those guys, were able to get them minutes when they would count, you know, with 12 minutes to go in the game, not just mop up. And both of those guys played great for us at Western, were a huge part of our success, made some big plays for us in the first half. And they've both been practicing great, and it just gives us confidence, you know, just that our bench will just be super deep on our bench.